More and more children are out of school, but parents don't want math learning to stop. They're turning to Mathnasium at home. Real-time math instruction tailored to your child's exact educational needs. It's the same face-to-face live instruction used in our centers for over 15 years, now on a computer. Your child can keep their math skills sharp, catch up, or soar ahead, from home or anywhere with an internet connection. To learn if Mathnasium at home is right for your child, visit mathnasium.com/at home. Mathnasium at home, changing lives through math.
Good day, everyone, and welcome back to Mathnasium Schoolhouse. As always, my name is Sandra, and I will be your instructor for today. Welcome to everyone who is joining us. I welcome you, as always, as with every lesson of mine, to say hello, let us know who we have here joining us today, and especially if you are a student, I'd love to know both your name and what grade you're in, or maybe what grade you'll be entering in September. Definitely share. Feel free to let us know who is here with us today. In just a few minutes, we will begin, and as always, I highly recommend having some sheet of paper with you, something to write with, again, to take down notes, to try out some of the problems that I welcome you to try out once we learn a few new techniques today. As you would have seen from the title of today's lesson, we are looking at counting, and we are going a little bit beyond basic counting, and we're going to explore what's it like to be able to count by any number. We'll focus a lot on whole numbers, and then from any number. Welcome, Jonathan, who's going into the first grade. Very nice to have you here. So in just a few minutes, we'll begin. Make sure you are prepared. Get those math muscles warmed up, ready to go. All right, so welcome everyone. Today we'll be looking at counting, as I said, we'll be able to count by any number, such as, let's say, twos, fives, tens, maybe even some not so nice looking numbers, sevens, nines, twelves. Wonderful, I see a lot of you joining and sharing. I love to see that, thank you so much. So being able to count by any number from any number. And what I mean by that, especially, is not just always starting at zero, but being able to count from any number out there, even if it's not zero or if it's not a multiple of that same number we're counting by. And so that'll really be able to test us and show us that we are, in fact, the master counters that we aim to be in our math journey. Welcome, welcome, everyone. So to take things a little bit further than that, we're also going to be exploring what's it like to count forward but also backward. So challenging ourselves that much more. Again, achieving that status of a master counter by the end of all of this. And at the end, if we have the time, we'll also look at what is it like to count by a half or one and a half. So just a little bit exploring what's it like to count beyond whole numbers. So a little bit of those fractions. So some of you might be thinking, if you're joining us today, you might be thinking, okay, Sandra, but I already know how to count. I know how to count one, two, three, which is great. That is exactly what counting is. But as I keep saying, we're going to learn and we're going to aim to be master counters, which means, as I said, being able to count by any number, from any number, to any number, both forward and backwards. So not just by ones. All right. Hopefully you're excited for that just as much as I am. And so to do this, as always, and to do this well, which is what we always aim for in our math studies, of course, we need to equip ourselves with some techniques, which is what I'll introduce you to today. Maybe you've seen them, maybe you haven't. Hopefully some additional practice will get those really ingrained in your mind. And they're going to help us count efficiently. What that means is just some easy, quick, reliable techniques that you can always turn to in your head, so you don't have to always rely on that piece of paper, or even worse, maybe count one by one, which just takes a long time and it's not so fun. So let's get started. Thank you so much again for everyone joining and sharing your name and grade level. That really helps me out to see who we have here today. Wonderful. So let's start with some of that basic counting. Let's just briefly see where we are with that, how comfortable we are. So when we count by a number, and I'll just turn to my whiteboard here. So of course, when we count by a number, we know that we are always adding that number each time. So simply put, if I'm counting by ones, let's say, so originally before we said one, two, three, four, five, and so on. When we are counting by ones, that simply means that we are adding one each time, right? 1 plus 1 gives me the 2, 2 plus 1 gives me the next number, 3, 3 plus 1 gives me 4, and so on. Which means, and we'll get started on our first question of the day, if I want to count by 2s, I just follow that same pattern. I then need to add 2 each time. So let me remove this, and I'll be using some templates here so I don't have to draw out too much. So let's say I ask you to count forward. We're going to focus on forward by now. So just count by 2s. And let's say I just want to start at 0. Again, just to make sure we're all on the same page here. So we're counting by 2s starting at 0. If my starting number is 0, I'm just going to include that here, just so I know exactly where I'm starting at. I know I'm counting by 2s. Sandra just told me that that's exactly what we're doing in this question. So let's go ahead. Again, if I count by 2s, I add 2 each time. 0 plus 2, and you can help count along with me, is 2. 2 plus 2 gives me the next number. 2 plus 2 is 4. 4 plus 2 will give me that next number, 6. And if we just fill in that last blank there, 6 plus 2 gives me that last number, 8. And we can keep on going. It just follows that same pattern. Perfect. Thank you for sharing. 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Wonderful. Now I want to ask you, does anything change if I want to add from a number that is not 0? Hopefully you're thinking right away, well, nope. And maybe I can show you that as well. So I will remove this one. And let's say we're still going to count by 2s and we're still going to count forward. Let's count forward by 2s. But let's say we're going to start at 3. Again, because that's my starting number, I'm just going to include that in this blue box here. And of course, when I am counting by 2s, that means following that same rule, we are adding 2 each time. And in fact, I can show that with just a plus sign here if that helps any of you out. So I'm not starting at 0, I'm starting at 3, but that's not a problem for me because I know how to add 2 each time comfortably. 3 plus 2 gives me my first blank. I know that that is a 5. 5 plus 2 will give me that next number, which is 7. 7 plus 2 will give me that next number, which is 9. And finally, 9 plus 2 will give me that last number here. And as always, we can continue that pattern. Oh my goodness, look at Maria. Very nice. Good job. Okay? So let me leave you with a question right now for maybe a minute. And I will write it out on another page here. I am going to ask that you help me to count again forward. But this time I want you to count by fives. And I would love for you to start at the number 45. Okay? So I'm going to just fill this in for you here. I'm going to start at 45. That's just what the question is telling me to do. It's also telling me to count forward by fives, which I know means I add 5 each time. So go ahead and take the next minute to fill that out. Or just include it in the comments. We'd love to see you guys sharing your grade. That's really helpful for me to see who's joining us today. Okay. So go ahead and tell me what that next number is after 45. If we are counting forward by fives, Sandra said counting means that we're adding that number every time. There we go. I see Maria. You have the next number. Perfect. So I will include that there. Hopefully the red shows nicely. It is in fact 50. If I take 45 and I add 5 more, I do get 50. And I see you guys are helping me out. Wonderful. So I'm just going to take your numbers and fill them in. Next number would be 55, 60, 65, and so on. And I see some of you went way beyond there. Wonderful job. Very good. All right. Perfect. So we're all on the same page right now. We know how to count comfortably. Well, we saw ones already. We saw twos. We saw fives. Now, we've been focusing on forward. Let's see what happens when we do backward counting. Let's just see. And some of you might already know this, which is great. You can go ahead and share if you'd like to. So let's first review what we observed when we were counting forward. When we were counting forward, we were adding a number each time. What do you think that means when we are counting backward? Instead of adding, we will. Help me fill in that blank. Some of you might be thinking, well, I know that the opposite of addition is in fact subtraction, and that's exactly right. So instead of adding this time, when we're going forward, we will subtract. So again, simply put, if I just want to show you just a very, very basic example, if I want to count backward by one, I am going to start, let's say, at 10. My next number will be 9, then it'll be 8, 7, 6, and so on. And how do I know that? Because, of course, just like Joselle mentions, and battle, very nice, when I count backward, I am subtracting by 1. 10 minus 1 gives me 9. If I take 1 away from 9, I get 8. 1 away from 8 gives me 7, and so on. Okay, that's just very basic backward counting. So let's get a bit more fun with our numbers. So what if I would like for you to help me out with, and again, I'll just pull out a template here so I don't have to draw too much out. This time, as I said, we are going to count backward, so I will fill that in. And you are going to help me count backward by fives. And I would like to start at 60. Okay. So my first value is 60. I will include that here. And I said, we are counting backward. And you all helped me figure out if I'm counting backward, I'm not adding, I am subtracting. So in this little circle here, I'm gonna help myself out by saying, I am subtracting, so just a minus sign, and the 5 there, okay? So when I count backward by 5s, one more time, I am subtracting by 5. So some of you have already helped me out, wonderful. Let me use maybe a red here. If I subtract 5 from 60, I get 55. Good, wonderful. Maria just helped me out the next one. I get 50 if I subtract 5 from 55. After 50, oh, perfect. You guys are just sending the numbers in. I get 45, and you guys helped me out with the last one here. I get 40. Again, subtracting 5 every time. So how about I give you maybe another problem to try it on your own? This time, I would love for you to count backward by tens. So count backward by tens, and I'd like for you to start at a really large number, 110. Okay. So I will help you out here. I'll give you a minute to try that out. And maybe I won't fill in this circle just yet. Let's see if you remember what to do when we are counting backward. Counting backward by 10. And if you manage to get those blanks filled in, take the next little bit while I wait for a few more of you to share your answers to think, is there a pattern? When we subtract 10, when we count backward by 10, is there a pattern that I can observe? Very nice. You guys are sharing the correct answers. Beautiful. I love to see it. Thank you so much for sharing. So I'm going to take some of those answers here. I see that a lot of you had the next number here after 110. You told me that it is 100. That is exactly right. And you guys got there by following the rule that I reminded you about. When we count backward, we subtract, and we subtract by the value we're counting by. All right. Oh my goodness, someone went into negative numbers. If you've heard of negative numbers, you can check out the comments that just showed up. Beautiful. All right, if I subtract 10 from 100, I get 90. If I subtract 10 from 90, I get 80. And if I subtract 10 from 80, and if you're not following along, another way to think of this is, well, 80 is 8 tens. If I take away 1 ten, 8 tens minus 1 ten gives me 7 tens, or in other words, 70. Okay? If you were following, if you maybe weren't following along there, that is the pattern that we are seeing when we are subtracting. Okay. So one more time, if you've observed a pattern, when we count backward by 10, meaning when we subtract 10, we are seeing, and maybe it's more apparent here, you're seeing that that tens number is changing and going down by 1 each time. Okay. For those of you asking what grade this is appropriate for, what level, I'd like to speak more about the levels that this is more appropriate for. And really, we're building up from counting anywhere from 1s, and we'll extend all the way to 12s. So a lot of these techniques will be helpful for a lot of your students in many, many grades. Okay? So I'm going to remove this, and let's keep in mind that pattern, and we'll look at one more example. This time we're going to go back to counting forward. So I'm going to ask you to count forward by tens. And please start at 49. So one more time, I will fill that in. We've already talked about this. We said when we're counting forward, we are adding, and we are adding by that number we are counting by. So in this case, we're adding 10. So remember the pattern that we just observed? How can we take that and help us out here? Maybe I'll include this in green this time. If I take 49 and I add a 10, we know that that 10's value is going to change. So this becomes 59, and there you go. I see Joselle helping us out a lot. After 59, Joselle also said that we get 69. Great. Maria, thank you so much for sharing. 79 and 89. I almost wrote 80. 89. So as I always love to say in my lessons, because something so beautiful about math is observing all the patterns and seeing how we can use those patterns to maybe a lot more faster get to our answers and just have more efficient ways of getting to some of our answers. So we're not constantly counting, in this case, one by one. If you can observe patterns anywhere and use them to help you go forward, please always do that. And another great thing about observing these patterns here is you can really catch yourself making a mistake. So always try to ask yourself, am I doing this correctly? Did I count correctly? And in this case, I know that these answers are correct. I know that the ones that you gave me are correct because they follow the pattern. So when I counted by 10, I found these values, but I can double check if they're correct to see if they followed the same pattern. So that's a really cool thing that we can keep in mind here. Okay. So maybe that was a review for a lot of you, and hopefully now the next two techniques that I introduced to you are fairly new and you can see how you can use them in counting larger numbers. So I will take this away. And maybe before I show you the next template, we'll have a little bit of a discussion first. So now, when we count by a number that takes us over the next tens number, and maybe you'll see that more clearly with an example, what we will see that we can do is we can actually add up to that next tens number and then add the leftovers. Okay? We are going to refer to this as the up to and over multiples of 10 technique. So you'll hear me use that language a little bit in this technique and in some of the additional exercises that we use. So let's look at an example. So I will pull out this template here. You might notice that it looks slightly different from the ones we were just using, but you'll see why it's helpful for us. So let's say that I want to count forward. I'm gonna fill that in. We won't look at backward for now. Since we're looking at a new technique, let's just count forward by now. Let's focus on just adding. And let's say I want to count forward by sevens, and I would love for you to help me start at 28, okay? What this technique tells us, and let me just fill in some of these values. I know that my starting number will be 28, and that altogether I am adding 7. What this technique tells us, one more time, is that we can count, right? If we want to count by 7, we'll notice that we're going to go over the next 10 value. Maybe you can help me out. What is the next 10 value beyond 28? You might not be able to see that if I write it in, but I'll say it out loud. The next 10 value will be 30. So you can already see if I add 7 to 28, I will go beyond 30. So this is where this technique is super helpful. Okay. So because I'm going to go beyond 30, I'm going to use the technique called up to and over multiples of 10. Which means that I need to figure out how much do I have to add to get to 30 first. I'll include a different color here. And then what is my leftover amount? And that is going to be a lot easier than adding 7, and you'll see why. So if my next tens number was the 30, how far apart are 20 and 30? You guys are jumping ahead, filling that in. For those of you that maybe don't know how to find that next number, please follow along. To get from 28 to 30, I have to add 2. But then what is left over to finish counting or adding 7? Well, I know that, and if I write this here, 7 is equal to 2 plus 5. And so that leftover amount is still 5. So perfect. Thank you for sharing. So I still have to add 5. But this is so much easier for me because I just have to add 5 to 30. And I know very quickly that 30 plus 5 is 35. And again, listen to that one more time. 30 plus 5 is 35. So that is my next number here. Let's try that one more time. Okay. And I see that you guys are jumping ahead. Very good. Continue to share your answers there. So to follow that same pattern, I think, okay, first of all, if I add 7 to 35, I know I am going beyond the next 10 number. So I'm going to use this up to and over technique here. The next 10 number is going to be 40. How far apart are 35 and 40? If I think for a few seconds, I know that they are 5 apart. So I will include that here. So to get from 35 to 40, I have to add 5. But based on the fact that I saw before, 7 is equal to 2 plus 5, which means I still have a leftover amount of 2. So I have to add that leftover amount to the 40. But again, that's super easy for me to do in my head. 40 plus 2 is 42. I can hear that pattern there. So I'll give you an exercise to try to practice this on your own. For those of you that already found the answers, I will fill this in. I know that you guys gave me 49 was next, and then you gave me 56. So maybe you can see that. So maybe I will keep this just in the corner here while I provide those of you that already found the answers with an exercise to practice with. Let me just move this over. So take the next few minutes to please answer this one for me. Count forward by 8s, starting at 29. And as I said, I will leave this page here in case you need to reference it to see what we did earlier. Let me fill this in for you as well. We're starting at 29. Count forward by 8s starting at 29. So remember what we did earlier. We knew that if we added to our first number, we would go above, higher than the next 10 number. Do you think that will happen here? Hopefully you guys are thinking, well, of course, because I'm only one away from the next 10 number, which is 30 in this case. I see you guys are already sharing your answers. Beautiful. So 29, we just said, is one away from 30. So that means I'm only adding 1 to get to the 30. But how much is left over to fully add 8? Well, I know in my head, 8 is equal to 1 plus 7, so there's 7 left. Can we easily add 30 plus 7? Absolutely. I know that right away. 30 plus 7 is 37. And so I have my next number. Maybe let's fill in one more. You guys are pros at this. I love it. You guys gave me 45 as the next number. Let's see if that's correct. I'll include that here. Let's see, I'm gonna follow along with this method for anyone that needs to see it, which means I will pull this away. We don't need that anymore. The next 10's number after 37 is 40, and I know that I have to use this technique for myself because I know that if I try to add 8 to 37, I will go beyond this multiple of 10. So I know that I'm going to rely on this technique here. How far apart are 37 and 40? I know that they are 3 apart. So I need to add 3 to the 37 to get to 40. How much is left over if I want to add a full 8 altogether? Well, I know 8 is equal to 3 plus 5, so there's a 5 left over, which means you guys are absolutely correct. The next number is 45. Because 40 plus 5 is 45, and so on, all right? So that's one technique. Again, we use that when we know that we are going to go beyond the next multiple of 10. Hopefully you find that helpful in your counting. I will move that aside and talk about our next technique. Our next technique we are going to call adding 10 first, right? And this means that when adding a number that is close to 10, whether it's a little bit above or a little bit below 10, we can add 10 first and then add or subtract something else. And again, we can think of that as that leftover amount. Again, this will be more clear through an example. So let's see what that looks like. One more time, because I don't want to draw all of this out. I'm going to pull out one of my templates that I made. Again, it looks slightly different. I just want to remove all the stuff that I don't need. So let's look at an example here. We are going to one more time count forward. This time we're going to count forward by a pretty big number. We're going to count forward by 12s. And we are going to start at 25. Okay. So you know that, of course, 12 is larger than 10. And it is, in fact, maybe I can write this here. 12 is equal to 10 plus 2. So it is larger than 10. It's two more bigger than 10. So, if I start at 25, let's fill this in as always. Because I know 12 is equal to 10 plus 2, I can add 10 first, and then my leftover amount. And I actually really, really like this method. It's so easy to do in my head because I know how to count by tens really quickly, and I know you guys do too. I can see it already. 25 plus 10 gives me 35. We already recognized that pattern from before. Then I just have two left over. I can even count by ones in that case. 35 plus 2 is 37. And so I get my next number. If I do that one more time, again, add 10, then add 2. 35 plus 10 is 45. 45 plus 2 is 47. And so on. Oh, I'm sorry. I messed this up. This was supposed to be 37. Did you guys correct me there? Sorry. Let's do this here. 25, I apologize for that. 37, and this was 49. My mistake. You guys had that. Just so that's cleared up, okay? But we're still following that same pattern. So 25 plus 10 gives me 35, plus 2 gives me 37. 37 plus 10 is 47, plus 2 is 49, and so on. And as I said, this technique works nicely for numbers that are a little bit below, above 10, but also a little bit below 10. So what if I asked you to help me out and count forward by nines? 9 is really close to 10. And let's say we start at 46. Let me just erase this. That's not needed here. Count forward by nines starting at 46. And because 9 is less than 10, instead of adding some leftover amount, we're going to subtract what we don't need to get to 10. So I put this aside. Before we saw 12 was equal to 10 plus 2, now we're working with the fact that 9 is equal to 10 minus 1. Okay. So in this case, if we start at 46, maybe I'll use a different color just to help us out. I can still add 10, and I want to because I really love to add by tens, and maybe we all should because adding by tens in math is very easy, very quick to do. So we're gonna try to use that as much as possible. But then I added one more than I needed to, so I have to accommodate for that by subtracting one. To do that, again, I'll use a different color here. 46 plus 10, I know that so quickly, it's 56. If I subtract 1, that's very easy for me to find, 55. Let's do that one more time. I'm going to add 10 and subtract 1. If I add 10 to 55, I get 65. And if I subtract 1, I get 64. And so on, which you guys are already finding for me. So let me just take your answers and share it here. 73 and 82. Beautiful. Thank you always for helping me out. How about I give you one more to try out all on your own? This time I'm going to ask you to count by 11s. So let me take this away and ask you to please, we don't need that, count forward by 11 starting at 24. Count forward by 11s, starting at 24. I'll help you fill this out. I maybe won't fill in this box just yet. I want you to think, how am I going to really quickly add this in my mind? One more time, count forward by 11s, starting at 24. What do we have? Share your answers if you have them. I see the next answer there. Very nice. It is 35. Oh, there we go. I'm seeing a whole collection of numbers now. The next number is, in fact, 35. Then we get 46. Beautiful. 57. 68. Good job, everybody. Very nice. And how did you get there? Maybe I'll share it here. Well, maybe I'll just write this here. 11 is equal to 10 plus just one more. Because I know that, I can easily fill in this little template here. Add 10. I always want to add 10 if I can. And then only subtract 1. Super easy for me to do in my head. 24 plus 10 is 34. Oh, I'm sorry. Add 1. Oh my goodness. Too many mistakes today. 24 plus 10 is 34, add one more is 35. One more time, 35 plus 10 is 45, add one more is 46, and so on. And you can start to see that pattern already. And remember what I said, if you can notice a pattern, then you can check if the numbers that you've listed are correct. I can see a pattern that when I count by 11s, my 1s values go up by 1, but so do my 10s values. So now I know I definitely did it all correct. Okay. If you guys want to try out a few more exercises, please go ahead. I'll leave them here. Okay. For example, what if we take what we learned a little bit further? Count by 20s. Ooh. And I want you to start at 126. Maybe just find the next two. And I'm not going to pull out a template because I want us to do this all in our heads. So I'm going to count forward by 20s. And just a side note, if I don't say anything, if I don't say forward or backward, assume it is always forward. All right? Okay. So if I want to count forward by 20s, you can think of this as just adding, because it's going forward, just adding two 10s. So whereas originally we worked a lot with adding one 10, now it's just a little bit step further and taking two 10s. So if I take 126, you guys are already getting it, beautiful. 126 plus one 10 gives me 136. One more 10 gives me 146. And you guys already shared the next answer, 166. Beautiful. So this is more in line with that very first technique that we saw, where we're just adding by these numbers. Let's practice then with another technique that we saw. What if I ask you to count by 18s? Look at that big number. 18s, and I would like for you to start at 57. Again, let's just fill in the next two numbers. You guys are going far, beautiful. All right. So if you want to count by 18s starting at 57, what technique did we see today that could really help us out? And maybe you're thinking, oh, Sandra, you showed us a technique that said we can add 10 first and then that leftover amount, right? Because 18, if I write it on the side here, is equal to 10 plus some number, and that some number is 8. So why don't we just use that here? And again, I'm not going to write it out. Let's just do this all in our heads. 57 plus 10 gives us 67. Plus 8. Ooh, some of you might find that challenging. So what can I do there? If I just think out loud what I'm going to do in my brain, I'm going to take that 67, and because I don't like to carry, I'm going to break down the 8 into a 3 and a 5, because 67 plus 3 can take me to 70, and then 70 plus 5 is 75, so that's beautiful. One more time, add 10 and then add 8. Well, 75 plus 10 is 85. Then I need to add an 8, but I just remembered that 8 is 3 plus 5, or in other words, 5 plus 3. And so you guys are sharing the next answer. If I add the 5 and then the 3, I get to 93. Beautiful. As always, if I'm going a little bit too quickly, these are always recorded so you can rewatch them and go back and pause it and try out these problems before the answer appears. I will give you one more problem before we end for the day, for those of you that really want to be challenged here. Let's say that we want to count backward this time by sevens. And I'm going to ask you to start at 150. Just give me the next two numbers. And because we didn't use that third technique just yet, you might be thinking, okay, Sandra definitely wants me to use that third one, which is correct. So see how you can use that last technique that I showed you here, which was called up to and over multiples of 10. The only catch here is that we're going backward. Okay. Bye-bye to anyone that needs to leave, no problem. So if you want to use that technique here and we have to count backward by 7, we said earlier that when we count backward, we are actually subtracting. So keep that in mind. Okay. So instead of going over multiples of 10 in this case, we're actually going, you can think of it as under. And you guys are already sharing the answers. Beautiful. So instead of simply subtracting by 7 altogether, we can follow some pattern. The only catch here again is that the nice thing about 150 is I can actually subtract 7 from it fairly quickly, right? I know that that's going to give me 143. So I didn't need any technique in that first step, but I think I need it for this next number, because if I try to subtract 7 from 143, I'm gonna have to borrow, it just gets a little bit ugly in my head. So I'm gonna rely on some sort of efficient technique to try to get to that answer. So the first thing I would think to do for myself is to get rid of this 3 so I get to a multiple of 10. The next multiple of 10, if I'm going lower, is 140. So I'm going to keep that in my mind. To get from 143 to 140, I have to subtract 3, okay? But then I need to subtract 4 more because I need to subtract altogether by 7. So if I take that 140 and subtract 4, you guys were already helping me out with that, I get 136. For those of you that maybe didn't follow along there, I subtracted 3 and then I subtracted 4 because I wanted to get to 140 first. As always, I have more of these practice problems in the packet that will be shared with you just at the end of this lesson today. We are coming to an end here, and the only thing that I would think some of you might find interesting is, well, if you were really following along here today and you found that counting by whole numbers was a little bit too easy for you, challenge yourself to count by a half, or even more, 1.5. So let's say I wanted you to count by halves, starting at 7. If you watched Larry's video last week, you guys were talking about half. You can use that logic here. And if you're very comfortable with halves and visualizing 7 wholes and adding a half, then you can see here, oh, this isn't too scary just because I have a fraction. All that this means is if I take 7 wholes and I add another half, I have 7 wholes and a half. What happens if I add another half here? And you guys are helping me out, thank you. I get a full 8, and so on, right? I can easily change up the question the slightest bit. Let me just fit that in here. What if I counted by 1.5s? Okay. The answers change the slightest amount. I just have to accommodate for that full whole that I'm also adding. So here I might decide to start with the 7 wholes and think, okay, I'm adding a whole, which gets me to 8, and then I have 1 more half left over. So I have 8.5. Yeah, you guys are following along, thank you. And let's try that one more time. In this case, I have 8.5. Again, let's add the whole first. I get 9.5. And if you need to visualize that for yourself, on your page, definitely do that. And then if I have 9.5 and I have one more half, I get to a full 10. And thank you so much, Lavanya, for helping me with that. Beautiful. Hello, William. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining me today. As I said, please feel free to review any of this, practice it, extend it in the questions that I have included for you in the packet that will be shared. I hope, as always, you're having fun with your math. And you share what you learn with your parents, with your siblings, with your friends. Always reflect, yes, always reflect on what you're doing. And if you want to be a great math student after today, after the things that we visited today, think about other cool creative ways that you can master count. How you can take any number and think of creative ways to add, right? Maybe you didn't like or prefer some of the methods here. For example, if I'm adding by 7, I might prefer to add 10 first and subtract 3. It's another technique. It's something cool. But you might also want to sit down and think, where would that technique not serve me well? Where would that maybe be more challenging to use? Why would some of these techniques that Sandra introduced me to today be more helpful? Take the time to reflect on that, to talk to somebody, consider adding with fractions, and on top of all of it, share, as always, why you care about being a master counter, right? Does this in fact help you be more confident in your math? Have fun with it. Do you find it easier? Do you find it cool? All right? Take the time to think about it. As always, I really appreciate you guys sharing your answers, talking with me today, engaging. Have a wonderful day. Stay safe, and I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye.
It's afternoons that seem to be the most hectic for us, so it was much more convenient when we found Mathnasium at home.
All right, so how do we do half of 5? I think one of the best things about at home is that it really feels like you're almost at home with the student in their house teaching them.
I'm in my comfort zone.
You can just ask for help and the instructor will come right to you.
With Mathnasium at home, I know that they're getting the help that they need.
Awesome, great job.
Mathnasium, changing lives through math.